Good morning. Thank you for being here. And I just had a very, very useful and constructive, fruitful meeting with the President-elect Marcos, and I said, and the Ambassador of Finland, Mr. Juha Pyykkö. And we touched upon issues like economy, human rights, the situation in the region, in the Indo-Pacific, and finally, I expressed my gratitude to the President-elect for the contribution of the Filipino community and society in Finland. I mean, hardworking, friendly people who live and work in my country, and it's highly appreciated. On the economic side, I raised the expertise that Finnish companies already are providing here in this country in terms of green transition. I mean, fight against climate change, like waste to energy solutions, circular economy, plastic waste management, where we have expertise, and I know that there is a demand for solutions here. Then we touch upon the needs for digitalization in our societies, e-governance, but then in different fields of economy. I mean, health, education, for example, and education is something that you might know that Finland is really good at the global level as well, and I would like to revive a dialogue between Finland and the Philippines, between our officials and even at the political level, on educational policies and then digitalization of education, because that's important even after the pandemic. In terms of human rights, I raised their importance because, you know, my native country is Finland's foreign policy is human rights based, and Finland is currently a member of the United Nations Human Rights Council, and we work on issues like gender equality, human rights of sexual and gender minorities, human rights and education, climate change. And these issues like rule of law, human rights, freedom of media, vibrant civic space, these issues have value in themselves and they are important. But they are important because we know, based on experience, that any and all well-functioning and successful economies and societies, they implement and respect human rights. Then on the Indo-Pacific, we touched upon the current situation, and I underlined the increasing interest of the European Union to strengthen engagement here in the region. Finland is a member of the European Union, and we would be interested in increasingly working with the region and the Philippines on trade, sustainable development, ocean governance, human security, cybersecurity, maritime security. And the EU's approach here is a balanced, open approach that we want to work with any partners who share our values. And with the EU being increasingly here, as an EU member state and Finland, we want to work on upholding international law and international rule-based order. And at this juncture, I raise the Russian aggression against Ukraine, because that's a severe breach of international law and international rule-based order. And you might know that Finland, we share a land border of 1,300 kilometers with the Russian Federation. Russia is and will be our neighbor. But the Russian aggression was against Ukraine, that has totally changed the security situation in my country and in the neighborhood there. And as the aggression by Russia, it's a breach of international law. It's not an European issue, it's a global international issue. That is what I underlined to the President-elect as well. So I said we had a very, very useful exchange of views, and I wished him all the best for his important work in this country. Thank you very much.
There are some few questions.
Sure.
You raised you mentioned that among the things you discussed with the President-elect of Russia and Ukraine conflict, in what way can Finland help the Philippines? Because the impact of that conflict between those two countries as well, not just in Europe but also here in the Philippines, specifically with the high prices of fuel and so on. So in what way can Finland help the Philippines in that sense?
I think what Finland and the Philippines can do together is exactly to uphold international law and international rule-based order. I mean, classically and traditionally, the Philippines has been a very active and solid member of the United Nations. So we have to work in order to preserve the multilateral international rule-based system, and that's very important. And about inflation, about, you know, fuel prices, we have to be very careful and clear here. The EU has no sanctions on all the agricultural products from Russia. Zero. The inflation due to fuel prices and grains, that's because of the Russian aggression. Not because of the sanctions. It's because of the Russian aggression, what we are feeling here in terms of inflation, or even higher inflation all around the world.
Last question.
Ambassador, the Philippines is bent on expressing its independent foreign policy when it comes to Russia in its aggression against Ukraine. But when you mentioned a while ago that you talked about this, did you also try to encourage the president-elect in supporting, in condemning this aggression of Russia?
Yeah, exactly. As you know, the current government administration here, the Philippine government, which we appreciate, they have condemned through the United Nations General Assembly resolutions. The Philippines has been in the group of countries condemning the Russian aggression. And what I convey to the president-elect is that I hope that his administration will continue to appreciate and respect this approach from the Philippine side in the future as well.
Thank you, Ambassador.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.